You gotta be ready. This is what you get self-defense stuff for. When I pulled up here, a lady's walking out the alley behind me. Another lady asked for a boyfriend or husband or somebody, a male name. Said, where is he at? She said he was in jail. Now I want to deal a little bit with being in a dangerous area, like you may have seen at the beginning of this video. Because everybody you see, you can't draw down on. So, you have to have good judgment. The standard is a reasonable man before you start taking action. But, if you get to the point where you are convinced that something's going to be going down that you don't like, you at least can take preparations. Like if a guy's walking down the alley and you've changed a couple directions and he's followed you and he's still coming at you, so you decide to just hold your ground. If you have cover, you get behind it. There's a pole or something like that. And if it gets too close, put your hand on your gun and tell them to stop. What are you doing? Leave me alone, I'm leaving. I hope you get a good reaction. That will probably work most of the time. You might get called a few names, racist, crazy, but whatever. As long as you can get out of there without shooting, that's your best bet every time. But now, as you're trying to back up, when you're on a street, alley, wherever, somewhere you didn't want to be, but you had to be, kid's car broke down, had to go pick him up, whatever the reason. Now you think you saw a glint of a weapon. So you put your shoulder to him, and without moving your hands too much, if your holster's at the right height, I just pulled my gun out of my holster, and it's right by my right thigh. And I'm standing here looking just like a normal person. And it gets closer and closer. Now I can see that it is a gun or a knife. So he gets a reasonable distance like this is. What that say right here is about 10 yards. This is when you tell him, drop the weapon. Now if you got the first jump on him, you don't fire. He drops the weapon, you tell him to back off, you leave, report it to the police. Now, if the circumstances goes bad, you got your pistol there, you're not brandishing, you're not threatening him, you can't bring up your gun if you were in fear of imminent serious bodily injury or death. That's not brandishing. Brandishing is when you, for no reason, are scaring or attempting to scare or cause alarm in other persons. So he has a weapon, he's approaching you, you tell him, drop the weapon, and he starts to move the gun towards you. You have to fire. First two are effective, you're done. If not, same thing. If it goes down, change place again so he doesn't know where you are. If all of a sudden he moves, looks your way, same thing. You have to establish why you're shooting. You can see the shooting that just went down across the country, because every shooting is a homicide, but you have defenses to the homicide. Self-defense, which this just was. Okay, the standard's a reasonable man, self-defense, imminent body, you gave him warnings, you told him to drop the gun, you gave him an opportunity to leave, and he didn't. Now let's say the situation was even more hostile than that. Now my brother, you notice I'm only firing six, because I'm an old revolver man. If I got a low capacity gun, I usually carry six. Easier than a magazine spring, and my timing, after 35 years competitive shooting, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, doesn't mess my timing up. I know when I'm empty instinctively. So one more shot versus my instinctive reflexes, I'll take the instinctive reflexes every time. Okay. Now let's say he has a weapon, and you're walking, and you see it. You have no cover. So your best bet at that point, if he's not pointing at you, again, get to the side, see if you can remove yours. Now while you're removing it, watch, because if you start to pull it up, his gun comes up, you got to come out and fire. Okay, if his gun doesn't come out, this is where you start to back up, keep your weapon hidden, don't let him know you have it, say, leave me alone, leave me alone. He pulls the gun up, come up again, fire. Okay? Now, if you have time, if it's a knife and you still have some distance, that's a different story. You can come up and say, drop the knife. If he drops the knife, good. You back off, he backs off, everybody goes home. If you pull up, say, drop the knife, and he charges you, have to take care of business. He goes down again. Always change direction so he doesn't know where you are. If he gets back up, that's what you have to do. That's self-defense. You gave him warning. You gave him the ability to leave, ability to disengage. You were trying to disengage. Any witnesses would see that. That you were trying to leave, gave him a warning to back off, but he charged you and attacked. He had no choice. So that's the fun drills to do. A lot of fun, but you really need to practice them. You got to get used to pulling it up, moving, shooting. And it's more fun when you have a little more people here. My shooting buddies couldn't come today. I was going to do some other different stuff. But practice the carjacking stuff, the weapon stuff. And always remember, not shooting is your best bet. Is there any way you can avoid it? I thought I'd cover one more scenario while we're out here. More of an up-close thing. This is a corner. You walk around the corner and the person's there. And as soon as he sees you, you see him reaching for a weapon in his waistband, you've got to react quicker than he does. It's you or him. Same thing. You don't have time to even say anything. As soon as you come around the corner, you see him. You got to get him. This isn't the Wild West. It rarely happens. But it does happen. Happens on calls. Happens when you kick in doors. Happens at home defense. When you come out of your room, go down the hallway, go around the corner, go down the steps. That happened. The gun is in my holster because I wasn't alert. Now, in the house, you'd have the gun. If you were in the house coming around this corner, you'd be like this. You peep around the corner, see him. But on the street, it's in the holster. Come around the corner, draw fire. Alrighty. Okay, the absolutely last scenario. Gun's in the holster. Walk down the street and a guy just jumps out at you from the doorway or whatever. You don't have your gun in your hand. Push him off, draw fire. Just like that. Alrighty. Knife, gun, you have no choice. Unless you use other martial arts tactics to control a weapon. Sometimes he might have a weapon in his hand. You push him off, draw, and he pulls a weapon. That's what you have to do. Same thing. He just jumps out at you. You don't see a weapon, but you can't do anything at this point. The only thing you do is either go in it or get space. If you want space, boom, back off, boom, boom. Okay, if you see a weapon. If you don't see a weapon, then it's your choice. If you can get in court and justify shooting an unarmed person, if he's 6'5" and 300 pounds and you're 5'6" and 150 and he's reaching to choke you, then you'll have to explain that in court. Just because you're unarmed doesn't mean going around choking and killing everybody, beating them to death. You're 80 years old. You're on oxygen. You're injured. You have a bad heart. A big bruiser criminal against an older person, then you might be able to justify it. So that part's your call because every scene is different. But you need space or control. And if he was pulling a knife and you have any fighting skills at all, grab the knife handle, his hand, whatever. You're probably going to get cut. If you grab the handle of the knife or the arm, because he can move the knife around, not like in the movies. But getting cut's better than getting stabbed. Grab it, control it, shoot. So, but that one's your call. But you have to have space to be able to get your gun out. But if he gets a hold of you, remember, when you have a gun, this isn't a wrestling match, this is a gunfight, because the gun is involved. So there's always a gun. That's what cops always are faced with. People say, why don't you just fight me? Say, sorry, I got my gun here. This is a gunfight now. Because if you lose, they have your gun, they can kill you. So you need space and you need control. Do whatever it takes. Bite, headbutt, smash his instep, whatever it takes. Knee him, headbutt him, whatever your skills are. You do it because you're fighting for your life. This isn't a game.